They are my defenders. Rises from the dead. Stronger than the king. He's a pirate now.
Here's good luck to Frederick's ventures. Frederick's out of his indentures.
When 20 now he's riding, and in a lonely he's meant to fly. Which prevent a major life, and his burdens will never die.
Here's good luck to Frederick's ventures. Frederick's out of his indentures.
Full-blown member of our band.
Hurrah!
My friends, I thank you all from my heart for your kind wishes. Would that I could repay them as they deserve.
What do you mean?
Today I am out of my indentures, and today I leave you forever.
But this is quite unaccountable. A keener hand is scuffling a sonata, coming out of a piano never shift a hand spike.
Hear, hear!
Yes, I have done my best for you. And why? It was my duty under my indentures, and I am the slave of duty. For as a child, I was regularly apprenticed to your band. It was through an error. No matter, the mistake was ours, not yours, and I was in honor bound by it.
An error? What error?
I may not tell you. It would reflect upon my well-loved Ruth.
Nay, dear master, my mind has long been gnawed by the cankering tooth of mystery. Better to have it out at once.
Poor lad!
Well, Frederick, If you conscientiously feel that it is your duty to destroy us, we cannot blame you for acting upon that conviction. Always act in accordance with the dictates of your conscience, my boy, and chance the consequences.
Besides, we can offer you but little temptation to remain with us. We don't seem to make piracy pay. I'm sure I don't know why, but we don't.
I know why, but alas, I mustn't tell you. It wouldn't be right.
Why not, my boy? It's only 11:30. And you are one of us until the clock strikes 12.
True. And until then, you are bound to protect our interests.
Hear, hear.
Well, then, it is my duty as a pirate to tell you that you are too tender-hearted. Or is it? You make a point of never attacking a weaker party than yourself. And when you attack a stronger one, you invariably get thrashed.
There is some truth in that.
Yes. You make a point of never molesting an orphan.
Well, of course. We are orphans ourselves and know what it is.
Yes, but it has got about. And what is the consequence? Everyone we capture says he's an orphan. The last three ships we took proved to be manned entirely by orphans. So we had to let them go. One would think that Great Britain's mercantile navy was recruited solely from her orphan asylums, which we know is not the case.
But hang it all, you wouldn't have us absolutely merciless.
There's my difficulty. Until 12 o'clock I would. After 12 I wouldn't. Was ever a man placed in so delicate a situation?
And Ruth? Your own Ruth, whom you love so well, was won her middle-aged way into your boyish heart. What is to become of her?
Oh, he will take you with him.
Well, I feel some little difficulty about you. Oh, it's true that I admire you very much. But I have been constantly at sea since I was 8 years old. And yours is the only woman's face I have seen during that time.
Poor lad.
I think it's a sweet face.
Oh, it is! It is!
I say I think it is. That is my impression. But as I have never had an opportunity of comparing you with other women, it is just possible I may be mistaken.
True.
If I were to marry this innocent person, and find out that she is, on the whole, plain.
Oh, Ruthie is very well indeed.
Yes, there are the remains of a fine woman about Ruthie.
Do you really think so?
I do.
Oh, then I will not be so selfish as to take her from you. Just as an act of consideration for you, I will leave her behind.
No, Gregor. This must not be. We are rough men.
You lead a rough life.
Not be so utterly heartless as to deprive thee of thy love. I think I'm right in saying that there is not one here who would rob thee of this inestimable treasure.
Not one!
No, I don't.
Keep thy love, Frederick.
Keep thy love.
You're very good, I'm sure.
Well, it's the top of the tide, and we must be off. Farewell, Frederick. When your process of extermination begins, may our deaths be as quick and painless as you can conveniently make them.
I will. By the love I have for you, I swear it. Would that you could render this extermination unnecessary by accompanying me back to civilization.
No, Frederick. I don't think much of our profession, but contrasted with respectability, it is comparatively honest. No, Frederick, I shall live and die a pirate king.
Hurrah! Oh, better far to live and die under the brave black flag I fly than play the sanctimonious part of the pirate head in the pirate hall. Away to the cheating world go you. But I'll be true to the song I sing and live and die a pirate king. For I am a pirate king. And it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king. For I am a pirate king.
It is a rock, a pirate king, a rock, a pirate.
more ships.
It's true than a well-bred monarch ought to do. Many a king on a first-class throne, if he wants to call his crown his own, must manage somehow to get through more dirty work than ever I do. For I am a pirate king, and it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king. For I am a pirate king, and it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king.
It is a
very dear to me, as you know. But I must be circumspect. You see, you are considerably older than I. A lad of 21 usually looks for a wife of 17.
A wife of 17? You would buy me a wife of 1,000?
No, but I shall find you a wife of 47, and that is quite enough. Ruth, tell me candidly, and without reserves, compared with other women, how are you?
I have a slight cold, but otherwise I'm quite well.
I am sorry for your cold, but I was referring rather to your personal appearance. Compared with other women, are you beautiful?
I've been told so, dear master.
Ah, but lately.
No, years and years ago.
What do you think of yourself?
That is a delicate question to answer, but I think I am a fine woman.
Well, that is your candid opinion.
Yes, I should be deceiving you if I told you otherwise.
Well, thank you, Ruth. I believe you, for I am sure you would not practice on my inexperience. I wish to do the right thing. And if you are really a fine woman, then your age shall be no obstacle to our union. Hark! Surely I hear voices. Who has dared to approach our often inaccessible lair? Can it be Custom House? No, it does not sound like Custom House.
Confusion! It is the voices of young girls! If he should see them, I am lost!
By all that's marvelous! A bevy of beautiful maidens!
Lost!
How lovely! How surpassingly lovely is the plainest of them! What grace! What delicacy! What refinement! And Ruth! Ruth told me she was beautiful! Above one, you have deceived me!
I have deceived you!
Yes, deceived me! You told me you were fair as gold!
As master, am I not so?
And now I see you're plain and old!
I'm sure I'm not a just soul!
Upon my innocence,
I'm not the one to plot so.
Your face is like
friends. I dare not show in this alarming costume. No, no, I must remain in close concealment until I can appear in decent clothing.